Hey y'all, it's Jeff with Team Catfish. Man, I just got a hit. I was punching in my live code right here. I think I got a fish right here on this Thundercat. It just laid down. I think the double action hook got him. And I'm gonna wait till I see another commitment. And I'm gonna see if I can. Here, this will be one of my deals. Never know how this is all gonna work out, but I'm gonna burn the reel. Let's watch that rod tip. Watch that rod tip with me here for a second. If you've never used the double action hooks, one of the best ways to use them is to go ahead and reel down. That line just went slack. I think that fish is coming at me. That or I missed him. Yeah, I missed that fish. Well, that's what I get for trying to do live. I don't even have the camera set up here yet. I'm trying to do this with my phone. I got a new boat, and I'm going to cast that one back out here in a minute. Maybe you guys can go catfishing with me. I'm trying to figure out. I've lost my tripod deal that I had, and I'm trying to figure out a way to make this work. That's not gonna work, so stick with me here, gang. Maybe, can you all see me there? Give me a comment. Hey, I see some people watching. Hope this sticks. Hope the camera stays right there. Let me go back up here and cast this rod out. I was using some shad, and I didn't have a lot of time to catch bait, so I'm that rod that got hit pretty hard right there while I was punching in my live code. I'm just using some little shad. I'm using some cut bigger shad, and I'm using some cut drum. Had a leaf on it. I thought something was pulling on that. Looked awful funny. I got a little bit bigger piece of shad on this one. This is the gizzard shad. Double action hook, sinker slide, sinker bumper. Kind of hang out here with me. How many people I got in the boat with me? 122 people. Awesome. Anybody got any questions? 124 people. This is the new G3 Bowcat boat. I've got it rigged up. I'm here in Oklahoma. I can legally use 6 rods here by myself in Oklahoma. So for those of you that are wondering, that's what's going on. I don't know. I guess you guys can see the rods. It's really, really hard for me to find a place where you guys can see everything and I can talk to you too. I know everybody likes to see the the takedown on the rods. I guess that's probably gonna be about as good as it, probably as good as it gets right there. I'm gonna use this clip and see if I can clip that to my rail. Maybe you can stick with me right there. I'm gonna move this, these two rods up so you get a little better view. I'm not doing anything difficult here, y'all. I'm still making sure I've got the new boat set up the way I want it. Again, I'm using some cut shad. I'm not using very big shad today. I do have some bigger shad, but I don't have a whole lot of them. So what I'm doing here is I've got my power poles down and I'm anchored in about 5 foot. And what I've got right here, out on this side of the boat, I've got a drop off. And it's not real steep. It goes from about 4 or 5 foot down to about 10 or 12 foot. My power poles are sitting in 6 foot of water. Over on this side of the boat, I've got a kind of an island. I've got an underwater island over here. And it comes up to about 3 foot. So I'm sitting on a brake line or transition line. There's a tiny bit of current coming around this corner of the river channel right here, and it's pulling the scent of my bait down that way just a little bit. I just got set up here and I was typing in my live feed information, and that second rod up there, the middle rod up there, went down, and I don't know, it might have been a little fish. I don't know what happened. I might have waited too long to get him. Heck, I don't know. But the fishing hasn't been real good here on the lake. The fishing's probably been better than I think. I haven't had a chance to get out here and fish very much, but here in the next few weeks, hopefully I'll get out here and get to do more of this stuff now that I got this bowcat lined up and you guys can watch me catfish out of this boat. This thing's like fishing off the front of a pontoon boat. It's so massive up here. So I got to figure out a way to get a camera or my cell phone back there to where you guys can watch me. But I wanted to stop right here real quick. I've got some obligations I've got to go to this afternoon. So I came out to see if I could get a little shallow water catfish feed put together for you. And I haven't been here very long. Anybody got any questions? Let me see if I can read this stuff. I got a guy over here, he has no idea where in the heck he's going. He's running through about a foot of water there right now. Sure hope he doesn't find one of them million stumps that's out there. Man, I got 138 people with me. Power poles do a pretty good job holding you out here. It's not real windy right now, but I do have two power poles on the back of this bowcat, and I got to leave a little bit of slack up here in my lines, but it'll hold me pretty straight. There's not a lot of current, just a little bit. The lake's falling right now. We had a big flood a few weeks ago, and lake's falling. They're still generating, drawing a little bit of water out of the lake, and that's why we've got a little bit of current coming around this corner right here. I marked some what I thought was catfish on my Lowrance side scan, and there's some fish up here in shallow, some fish. It's there's not just a lot as many fish as I would like to see up here in shallow water. When they really get up here good, if you guys have never watched the videos at the Team Catfish YouTube, you ought to watch some of those shallow water catfishing videos where we show you the fish on the locator, the catfish, and then we stop and catch some of them. That's the same technique I'm doing today. I just didn't spend a whole lot of time looking. I wanted to come up in this area here and see if I could find one. Get all them boat waves out of the way, maybe a catfish will come by. Man, it's hard for me to see, guys. I can't see the comments. I got some bigger shad and that cut drum in here, some drum that I'm using for bait. I'd much rather use the shad than the drum, but there's a hit right there. He's not a big cat. He is a catfish. A little blue cat. Like I said, not a big cat, but the old double action got him, and I'll show you a little bit more about this rig right here. And I might have to switch some of these other ones over to the smaller shad. That might be what these fish are keyed in on right here. Tell him bye, everybody. Say bye-bye. I'll show you how I'm hooking these shad on here. Again, folks, these are just little gizzard shad. I didn't have time to look for a bunch of big shad today. Little shad. I just put that through the meatiest part of the fish. I really like to hook these little gizzard shad right through the thickest part of their bodies. Like that. Make sure you always clean the tip of your hook off, and that's enough bait to catch some nice catfish. I like the bigger shad because they stay on a little bit better. But so that's two little shad right there, little 3-inchers. I put that on an 8-aught double action hook, and we go down to the 50-pound leader. Then I've got a sinker bumper right here. Right there, you get them teamcatfish.com, or you can find dealers at teamcatfish.com. Got the sinker slide, 3-ounce clip-on disc sinker. And this is a Thundercat spinning rod, gold ring spinning reel, 65-pound tug-of-war braided line. And let's get this back out here. Now, I caught that fish on some small shad. Woo-wee! There we go. Man, he buried that. Did you all see that? Thank you, Driftmaster Rod Holder. Woo-wee. I hope you all saw that takedown, because he smashed that rod. Oh no. I had another one hit on this rod right here. Not a real big cat, a little bit bigger than that last one, but he hit that bigger piece of cut shad that I just threw out there. So, all right, guys, stick with me here. We're doing some live catfishing at Team Catfish. Now I'm gonna get out my dead red spray. Spray that bait down again, because it's still pretty good. And I'm gonna get some. When you're out there and you're struggling to get a lot of bait, or you're in a hurry and you just got a small amount of bait, quit throwing your bait away. Spray it down with dead red. Watch this. Spray it down with dead red and throw it back out there again. Holy moly, I think I got a catfish on this other one up here. Mess. That catfish was carrying that all the way out there. He was carrying that around the corner there. That's got a shad head on it. That's still a good bait. You can see the double action hook and the shad head right there. Okay, I got some drum meat on this one. I'm gonna spray it down. Now look at there. That looked good enough to eat, doesn't it? Now I'll get back to what I was doing over here. I was trying to get this one reeled in, and I'm gonna put a couple new baits on it. I got drum on this one. I'm gonna put some shad on it. I'll show you how I cut them up while I watch these rods. Help me watch the rods, y'all. Holler real loud if something goes down. Okay, now what I'm gonna do here, for those of you guys that like to see what everything we do here, we got two small shad. I'm gonna cut them in half right here, right behind the black dot on their back. This Bowcat's got an awesome workstation right up here. I got my Team Catfish handy dandy hand towel right here. Right here on this workstation. And I'm gonna take those, and again I'm gonna hook them on through the thickest part of the shad. I'm gonna run that double action hook right through him. Maybe they'll keep biting, maybe we'll get another one here. So I put those two little shad on this one hook, and that's what I end up with right there. I'll cast it back out there and see what happens. A lot of boats out here right now, so make sure you leave plenty of slack in your line. Y'all, when you're out here, leave a lot of slack in your line so your boat can sway around. I'm only fishing in 5 foot of water, 6 foot of water, so. But that's pretty good view. I almost need a little bit more of a wide angle lens. I was gonna see, maybe I can get over here and see. Can't see comments. Maybe that's comments. I can't tell. Nah. I screwed up. I can see I got 205 people in the boat with me. It's getting kind of crowded. Let's give them a few more minutes here and see what happens. If you guys have never used the Dead Red before, what I was spraying them down with, great on frozen bait, great on shrimp, livers, worms. As you can see, I'm spraying it on my cut bait. This stuff's available at just about every major retail account in the country right now. Big retail account, big box store. We got something happening over here. Oh, here we go. That's the one I just sprayed down right there, y'all. Just sprayed that down. That fish is in 3 foot of water. Again, not another big cat, but boy, it'll be great for the skillet. Catfish sandwich stuff. He's a little bit bigger than the last two. Not a whole lot, but a little bit. But he chomped down on that. That bait had that Dead Red on it. He wasn't afraid, was he? Look at there, y'all. That's what y'all live for right there. Catfishing. Blue cats, channel cats, flatheads. Woo-wee. I'm gonna let him loose and put on some more baits. You guys can bait up with me. And I'm letting them loose today because I don't have time to clean them this afternoon. And I just wanted to come out here and catch some fish. And keep rigging the G3 Bowcat up the way I want it. Sorry, I kind of got a little bit of a runny nose. Let's cut up a little bit bigger shad this time. All right, got a little bit bigger shad. I'm going to cut his head off. I'm gonna cut these pieces right here about as wide as my fingers. And then always throw the tail away. I just don't fish with the tail very much. And I'll show you how to bait that hook up. I always like to run these hooks through the meatiest part of the bait. But you don't wanna close the gap up on your hook, okay? And what I mean by that is you don't want to close this area up on your hook right here, between here and here. You want to make sure when that fish gets that hook in his mouth, that's going to get him. And the harder they pull on these double action hooks, the faster that hook is going to get that catfish. But so many people make the mistake of crowding this gap right here. They put too much bait in here and the hook can't do its job. Never used the gold ring reels before, you're missing out. They cast like a dream. If you like bait casters, they've got two wind control dials on them, so they're really, really hard to backlash, and they just cast and cast and cast. All right, guys, that's three. We got three in the boat. My phone hasn't died. I appreciate you going fishing with me. You can find all this gear, the Eat Sleep Catfish. You can find all this or a dealer at teamcatfish.com. There's a lot of things at teamcatfish.com that some of our dealers don't sell, and a lot of our dealers don't sell everything that we manufacture for catfishing. But anyway, I'm going to get out of the way here so you guys can see the, if we get another takedown. I just can't do the comments and let you guys and set this phone right here where you can see the action on the bowcat. This is a G3 20-foot bowcat. It's got all the lights and stuff on it for bow fishing at night, or you can use these lights for fishing at night for stripers or crappie or white bass. And I put Driftmaster rod holders all the way around here so you guys could get out here and go catfishing with me and see what I was doing. We got a jackass over here. He has no idea he's in about a foot and a half of water, so I hope he doesn't hit a stump. He just doesn't care at all. He just ran right over where I just cast my lines. And I guess it's hard to stop stupid, but anyway, the old bowcat's got a 150 Yamaha 4-stroke on it. Oh, there was a hit. Little tap up there on that front left rod. It's got two 10-foot power poles on it. It's got an 80-pound thrust Trova trolling motor on it. I've got Lowrance electronics on it, an Elite 9 TI on the dash, and then I've got a Hook 7 up here on the trolling motor. Again, using Driftmaster half-inch Pro Duo rod holders, Team Catfish, Thundercat, casting and spinning rods. I've got all my spinning rods on this side. I've got my casting rods on this side. Gold ring, Team Catfish gold ring reels. These are the casting reels. These are the spinning reels. Tug-of-war braided line. I'm using either 50 or 65-pound braided line on all these. I think I've got the 50 on the spinning and the 65 on the casting. 8-aught double-action hooks. 50-pound monofilament leader. Sinker slides. Sinker bumpers. Haven't had to get a catfish big enough to get my fish grip out yet, but it could happen here any second. 183 people still with me in the boat. I know you guys don't like for me to shut these feeds off. I apologize. The one we were doing earlier this week, it was cold and my phone went dead. I don't know how much battery life I got on this one, but if it just goes dead, that's what happened. Find all these products at teamcatfish.com. We're fishing in Oklahoma where it's legal for one person to fish with 6 rods. So if you guys want to come to Oklahoma, we're on Grand Lake of the Cherokees right here. Beautiful reservoir, my home lake. I've caught a bajillion fish out of this. It's a great fishery. blue cats, channel cats, flatheads, crappie, black bass, white bass. Fishing is fantastic. Lots of places to stay. Great place to come fish. We're up in the upper end of the lake on the mud flats up here, and you go down toward the dam and it's real deep, a lot clearer water. And lake's about 55,000 acres. Got 1,300 miles of shoreline around this lake, so there's a lot of coves. There's a lot of place to get out of the... Coming at me fast. Oh, he was coming at the boat and I just couldn't keep up with him, y'all. Crap. Well, let's spray that head down with some dead red and see what happens. That line went slack, and when it went slack, I started reeling. I just didn't get caught up with him. Bloody shad head.
Dead red blood spray. Ooh.
Well, I was hoping we might stick a 20 or 30 pound fish while we're dink-donking around here and you guys are fishing with me. Still got 178 people with me. I'll just keep it running to as long as I sit here until my battery dies. I wished I had a way of communicating with you on audio, via audio, so I could hear your questions while I'm trying to watch these rods. I usually got somebody with me that's watching the questions, and I try to go over everything, and I tell you to buy this stuff at Team Catfish so much I just feel guilty, but this feed right here will have I don't know how many questions about where do you buy this, what kind of rod and reel is that, where are you fishing, how come you're using so many rods, all those questions, how deep's the water, what's the water temperature. I can't see when all that comes in, but I try to talk about it. The water temperature is 51 degrees. I'm in 5 foot of water. My power poles are down. I'm on Grand Lake of the Cherokees, where you can use 6 rods per person. Northeast Oklahoma. The fishing has not been just spectacular, but this is my first stop and I managed to eke out 3 fish. Missed 2 more right off the bat while I was trying to get the live feed going. I'm using 3-ounce sinkers. They're attached to the sinker slide, Team Catfish sinker slides. I made a cold drink of water. This Bowcat has just got tons of storage in it. And this workbench up here, I think you can see it right here. It's so hard for me to see in that phone. I think you can see it. But this workbench, I got my pliers. I got my Eat Sleep Catfish Slime Buster hand towel right here. I got my knives over here. I can bait my rods from the front of the boat. I can come back in here and bait my rods. I'm fishing with cut drum and cut shad, gizzard shad. I'm using some dead red blood spray. And we're just waiting on another catfish to bite. I've got a drop off up here in front of the boat. These rods in here are about 2 or 3 foot of water over here. These rods are in 6 or 7 foot of water, so I'm fishing the transition. I'm fishing this break line right here where a catfish might be in a little bit deeper. He might be feeding over here in a little bit shallower water. It's time for him to move up really shallow here and really start feeding. The lake's fallen, so that's slowed everything down. We had a big flood a few weeks ago, and the lake is falling. They're pulling the lake right now, and there's a little current coming around this corner right here, and it's kind of moving the scent of my bait out down that way. There's a hit over here. Oh, we just let it go. This far left rod over here. You can't see it very good, but it did get a hit. I used my Lowrance side scan to find these fish. I found some shad kind of mixed in there with them. And you can see them on all the units today have pretty good side imaging. Lowrance, Hummingbird, Garmin. They make a good side imaging, but you gotta learn how to use it. After you learn how to use it, you can find these catfish up in shallow water. And this is a big time spring pattern here in the Midwest and the South. Anywhere we got shallow water and blue catfish, you can find these fish up here. And when you learn how to do it, you come out and take advantage of these fish all the time. Every year, from season to season, you can target these fish. They won't be up here a lot in the winter, and they won't be up here a lot during the day in the summer, but at night they'll catfish. The blue cats will move up here in these shallow flats at night, so the flatheads move around. The flatheads are pretty hard to find on sonar equipment, but the blue cats is what I fish for the most, and they're very targetable. Come on, pull that thing down now. Quit messing with that. Can y'all see that pole up there? I don't know what he just not pulled at all.
Same deal.
He ate my shad head that I had sprayed down with the dead red that time. Let's put another shad head on there. I'm going to put this one crossways. Right through the bone, right through the hardest part of that head. You can see how I put that one on there. Got one rolling over here. I don't know what he's doing. Maybe the boat was moving. These Thundercats got a light tip on them, and if you learn how to watch them, you can start to see that commitment from that catfish out there on that tip of that. That fish was coming at us, and he's not very big. He was coming at us, and I saw that fish pulling that line through that sinker slide. So I went ahead and reeled down and got him. That's the beautiful thing about double action hook. They can hook yourself or you can reel down and get them. Give him a kiss, y'all. I know you love the catfish. That's the 8-aught red double action hook right there. Let's bait it up, get it out there again. That's 4. Maybe old Moby Dick will come swimming through here in a minute. We're gonna put on some more shad pieces right through the thickest part of the shad. Don't crowd your gap, y'all. Don't crowd that gap. Leave that hook exposed. Leave that gap open so that hook can do its job. Well, bam, bam, 2 fish. Missed one, got one. That's a long feed. My old phone battery's hanging in there. Boy, I tell you, there's some people out here that's just about to tear up their boat if they don't watch what they're doing. A lot of people that are out here are fishing for paddlefish or spoonbill. They're snagging paddlefish. People come from all over the United States to snag and catch paddlefish here at Grand Lake. It's one of the best places in the whole world to catch paddlefish. Oh, sorry everybody, I got some, that time of year, I got my allergies going. Phew, I'm getting hot. There, he hit one of them logs out there. I hope you heard that. That's guy that just come here on the right-hand side of the boat. I've been telling you on the live feed about how shallow that water is over there. Well, that boat that just come over here, that we're going to get his waves here any second. He just hit a big old log out there with a boat full of people. They make these things called depth finders that work really good. They can really save you a lot of problems. Okay, let's do the rundown again, y'all. Since this live feed's there, my battery's getting ready to it says low battery mode. I'm going to wrap it up here. I appreciate you guys getting in the boat with me today. I've had as many as about 250 people in here with me. We're in northeast Oklahoma. We're fishing with 6 rods. It's legal to fish with 6 rods here. I'm in the new G3 Bowcat, 20-foot Bowcat. Got Driftmaster rod holders, Team Catfish rods and reels, Team Catfish line, Team Catfish hooks, sinker slides, sinker bumpers. I've got my power poles down. That's what's holding me right now. And I appreciate you guys jumping in here and going fishing with me again today. If you haven't been to our YouTube channel, jump over there. We've got about 40,000 fans on YouTube. There's over 100 videos that you can watch. Make sure you subscribe over there on YouTube. And between YouTube and Facebook, that's where we do most of our posting. So anyway, Again, you can find all this equipment or a dealer at teamcatfish.com. If you want this product in a store near you, you've got to be the one to go in and ask for it. These dealers want to know that that this product is going to leave their shelf once they stock it. So once they have a have some people that are ordering and buying products or demanding products, a lot of times that's when you can get this stuff stocked. Team Catfish can be found at a lot of the big box stores around the country, including Walmart this year. And if your Walmart does not carry it, you need to go in and say, hey, I know this stuff's at some of the other Walmart stores. Can you please get it in here? And if they hear that enough, they will. So anyway, I'm Jeff Williams. Thanks for watching our videos. Facebook, thanks for supporting our brand at Team Catfish. Thanks from everybody at Yamaha and G3, the new G3 Bowcat. And we appreciate you guys supporting our company. I'm going to sign off.